Hey Spike. Hey Enemy. Oh, awesome. Oh, that's so nice. It surprised me with the whole quarry, the portal. Okay, nice. Yeah, plan is today. I probably want to work on the front part here. Not sure if we also start with the frosted ice stuff, but yeah, let's get started. So stream for 3 hours again. Gotta leave at 9 sharp because I just want to go for a little run afterwards and use the daylight. Hey, bis unter, which new version? There we go. No, is there anything interesting? Don't know, didn't even know that they made a new version. Okay, seems like this got cut somehow. Well, anyway, start with the lowest layer. Okay, there it is. Ah, oh, redstone on observers. Nice. Yeah, that it's good that they fixed it, because there's probably not a lot of uses for that. Also, in some cases it might be useful, but yeah, doesn't make sense in the first place, and I don't know, wasn't really that useful. It's good. Better fix it now before we get used to it and find nice uses for it, and then gets removed. Oh, it seems like somebody was working on the modules here. This is the 7th module already. Like Enemy was playing a bit, yeah. So, yeah. Could be that the quarry is finished soon. Also, they want to stream tomorrow again? Just to make more progress. I think we're getting there. Okay, I have to pull up again from here from the side. This layer is just too low. Oops. Awesome enemy. So, what should we do? Never know how to build those things. Maybe the... Yeah, I guess leaves here are good anyway. The horror layer as well. Oh, thanks, Panic. But it's not that bad now with the tweaker roof feature. So leaf placing is still not that good, despite being nobody on the server. Seems like it's a connection or whatever. Sometimes fails. Tweak a roof for Bed Wars, but it's cheating then, right? Wouldn't use it. You get an advantage over other players. Should we get some music going? I have some music. Can't you hear that? Oops. Yeah, I probably won't hear the music in Discord, obviously, yeah. Aren't there even Discord music bots? Might be also interesting, maybe, but get too annoying in the long run. Okay. Yeah, I don't think we need a music bot. It's fine. Hey, Daniel. It's falling down, but it's probably still better than do the slow bridging. It's falling down 8-9 times is probably okay. Happen again. Oh, come on. Because if I do this all the time, it just takes too long. Hey, Iceberg. Spikes is the Patreon gravel farm is finished. Oh sweet, so much gravel. How much is it? I've seen it already, but never in action. Five hours and about 250k gravel. Oh, that's good. So like 50k per hour. Yeah, this is should be enough for most cases. Yeah. Then of the sand farm, you can also get concrete powder now. Yeah. And dirt technically for the gravel. I really like the idea that we had in the end to get the clay. So put pots all in a cauldron, and then it turns into a clay ball. Um, Yeah, I heard about the 1.13 hopper chunk loading not working anymore. It was so unnecessary that they changed that. But we're definitely gonna re-implement it somehow on the server, because not spending 1k hours just to say it's vanilla. So if the hopper loading doesn't work at some point anymore, we just have to mod it back in, because it's just insane what we all build around that mechanic. Might as well just start a new world at that point, and that gets removed. What is the motivation of fixing that? I don't know, I have to be careful making accusations, but that's probably not a good reason. I don't know much about it, just what I read today in the Cycroft chat. So maybe the guys that actually already checked out the code, they can probably tell you. Let's get more rockets. Yeah, so from what I've read in Cycroft chat today, that all those changes are completely unnecessary, probably just done in order to mess with stuff. I don't know. Don't like it at all. It seems like either it was a failed attempt to fix something, or it's an intended feature removal again. Just a mess of the tech community, seems like sometimes, but yeah, probably isn't. But it's just odd. Yeah, the problem is with doing our own stuff is that, I don't know, we just don't get the acceptance. We have carpet, yeah. It's probably as good as it gets. Hey, Dracula. I'm kind of tempted just to use more leaves over there. It's probably also useful. Yeah. Yeah, I don't like that. That's not vanilla discussion at all. I mean, there are some purists that, I don't know, that just strictly don't use anything modded, and I can also respect that. But in my opinion, at some point it's just not fun anymore to always fix the stuff. If you could just mod it back in. At least we have the opportunity now, since we have a few guys that can write mods for us, and yeah, I don't see reason really to stay 100% vanilla, just, I don't know, just to claim it's vanilla. Is carpet open source? Their plans to make it open source, but as far as I know, it isn't at the moment. Yeah, it's really about playing the way you enjoy it. Yeah. Of course, there's a thin line. You have to be careful with modding the game so it doesn't get boring. Because look at modded. For me, playing modded is like fun for 2 weeks and then it's boring. And if you would push it too much with additional features and so on and make it too easy, then also vanilla would go the same path. But in case you're careful, there shouldn't be any issue with it. Hey, Hero. The slime calculator instant. No, wouldn't be possible. You could make it faster. So that you can also probably improve it a lot because it's like the first time we ever did something like that, and it's probably a lot of stuff we could improve, but make it completely instant? I don't think so. Oh hey, Santiago. I think you can't do the subtraction mode instantly, as far as I know. So you can send a signal instantly, but I don't know if you can do a subtraction instant. At least I haven't tried it yet. Yeah, we've done a bit of RNG stuff from Cycroft, but we agreed to not push it too far, because if we would use it for every single mob farm, I mean, it's always the same, always built the same chunk loading stuff and so on, it would get rather boring. It's a lot more fun to build dedicated iron farm, build a dedicated witch farm and so on. So we kind of decided not to use it to its full extent. Oh, that's a good question. Are you going to use carpet mod method of getting packed ice or the vanilla? I can't decide it on my own. If it were about me, we would do the anvil mechanic. Because I liked it. And it has the advantage that it could be automated. But a lot of people would like to stay in vanilla if there's really no other reasons, so I'm probably gonna stay in vanilla then. I can craft it. Maybe you can even have a discussion. I mean, the anvil mechanic is not super overpowered, it's actually quite complicated or complex if you really want to make a machine out of that. So why not have two mechanics? People that want to craft it can do so. Yeah, if you want to make a nice machine with that, it's also an option. But we'll see. Alright, some slime next. Some kind of angle we can place two. Yeah. We're making the Mesa Quarry mainly to get terracotta. And the main reason is to make a quarry. Bragging rights, yeah, that sums it up more or less. It's also nice, we're getting a ton of dirt, which we don't have millions of yet. Also, a lot of the rare stone types. It's definitely nice. More for the orange terracotta. No, not really. More for the, yeah, the normal, which was previously the hardened clay, the normal one. I think it's just called terracotta now. That's the main reason. I've been really lazy since last Saturday, since the 12-hour stream. Kind of wanted to build an iron farm, but I don't know, just had no motivation at all. Was making something different yesterday, but then I watched the World Cup games. It's also probably sometimes nice just to relax. Also, I'm kind of sore everywhere because I joined the gym last week and it's definitely different exercises that I haven't done in that form before, and this is definitely a challenge. TDL actually already has his iron farm thing finished. Now we just need to do some testing first because we want to use a new chunk loading system, and as I said, I'm gonna build a small iron farm. I'm probably gonna build Eater's 16 village iron farm. And test this first, and this works fine, then we're gonna build the big one. So we don't need to build the iron farm with the spawn chunks anymore. Visual Basic says I'm a map maker and I'm really looking forward to future releases with data packs and custom stuff. Might be possible to fix game issues like hopper duping with that API. Okay, interesting. Yeah. But as far as I know, hopper duping is already fixed. Sticky pistons. Is there a video on how the slime farm lamp display works? Not really. I've explained it a few times what the major components are, what the major circuits, but not in every little detail. Okay, maybe add it to the list of videos I want to make. But that list is already long by now. What's in the list already? Yeah, no spoilers, obviously. Also, kinda need to make a ton of tutorials on like the brewing system or that simple tree farm or the frosted ice pathway maker. Yeah, I'm not really that crazy about the frosted ice stuff anymore since it kinda creates trouble with chunk loading. So we actually made a 6,000 block long frosted ice line. Thanks for the raid, Fox. In survival, and that thing would keep chunks loading, loaded, and actually makes a permaloader on its own. It's pretty bad. Thanks a lot, High Order Failure for the resub. Oh, the mango song only plays if somebody hosts or raids me. Yeah. I had it for the follows for a while, but I have to be honest, it got annoying. What's the worst that could happen when you start a server on a pre-release? Don't. But I don't know what could happen. Everything. On the other hand, there have been full releases that were still quite buggy. So I don't know. I definitely recommend maybe not to even start with 1.13 flat. Wait for the first one or two subversions. Shouldn't it only place... What? From the slime farm? So all the slime for the farm was made in destruction. Yeah, thanks a lot, Iceberg, for the sub. So all the slime for the quarry, which is about, I think, was it 80k or 60k blocks, yeah, could be made in 2 or 3 hours with the slime farm we have, so it's no problem. Oh yeah, the rotator block indeed. Yeah, we only have 1 million slime at the moment, that's true. But I kind of need to rework the whole crafting system, the storage system. That's also gonna take a while. Other option would be to fix my script, but I really don't want to do it. I think it's better just to use some vanilla mechanics, so I don't need to use a sophisticated script anymore. And then we can do some AFKing again. Not sure if astro is really the right word for it. Isn't astro star? Not sure. They're renaming it. Better. Okay. Might as well get my leaves. Are the villagers left? I would assume. What is. Yeah, it's just this one house left. So maybe not. There might be another village somewhere. Also, did you know that 2% of all the villages don't have villagers, but zombie villagers to generate? It's crazy, didn't know that. Ja, Säule Green. Ups. Oh, we don't need to get rid of the leaves. Okay, so change something. Face, not plain. I'm quite sure leaves can be completely ignored. I think we should affect them. Maybe we shouldn't build them directly like in front of the TNT tubers. So that's obvious, but apart from that, they shouldn't interfere. Works much better without the beacon effects somehow. So without speed boost. Oh, okay, jinxed it. Won't the TNT destroy the blocks that drop? But that's the plan. Oh, you mean that? Yeah. So we push them in while the TNT is exploding, and then they have a 100% drop rate. Obviously, that's probably not really intended. That is something we found out a few years ago. And Mojang wants to mess with us, they could easily remove that, and then TNT is no longer a viable option again to break blocks. Which would be really unfortunate. Oh, you're forgetting clean code iceberg. Also, Panda already made a bug report about that. Did we show the leaf farm last stream? No. I showed him in the Cycroft episode a while ago, a year ago. Oh yeah, I'm also afraid about the clean concept, especially when it comes to redstone. Haven't heard anybody say so far that redstone and bedrock is better than Java. Oof, rewrite of redstone in Bedrock? Oh yeah, he mentioned something like that, yeah. But he's no longer involved really, as far as I can tell, he's just suggested to do that. But what was actually interesting, he said that they didn't know about the difference with game ticks and redstone ticks. So they didn't even know that that's important, that the redstone system doesn't just run strictly on a redstone tick basis for a lot of stuff. It was actually surprising that they were that clueless about some of that stuff. Light effect from redstone? I think the only light effect that is left from redstone is torches, but I think that should be intended that a torch emits light. Oh, that's true, furnaces in the villages. Yeah, that's something I have thought about, but it could also happen, yeah. Yeah, and we need to move some non-movable blocks. There's really no way around it. But it should be just a few hundred, so it's okay. Arbitrary code execution glitches? No. I think the only time I heard of that was in a really old Super Mario game on the Super Nintendo. And yeah, I haven't heard it possibly any other game. Probably systems now are too sophisticated in order to allow that. Back then everything was really written in assembly, and then yeah, everything was a lot easier and could access that code for some kind of a glitch. Super Mario Brothers. Okay, yeah. I think it's just a thing in those old games. How much of the quarry is done in percent? I'd say 70. Just gonna go to a copy of the survival world, locate all of that stuff with spectator mode, write down the coordinates and remove it in the survival world afterwards. Isn't that cheaty? Why? Who are we cheating? Yeah, there's really no better way. Another option would be to stop the quarry after every layer, move it manually, but then we can't run it 24/7 really, and we need to babysit the quarry all the time. Okay, Dragonkiller says, the Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess has a small exploit. You mean also with arbitrary code execution? So you could write your own code or what? Muslim. Yeah, we could use X-rays, but not entirely sure if that's the best way. We'll probably also check with MC Edit afterwards, because I don't want to risk this thing breaking. It's also not completely impossible that a new obsidian would generate if somehow a water stream gets redirected, whatever, and hits another lava source, but it's really, really unlikely, since we are above the lava lake layers, so yeah, that could also become a problem. I hope it doesn't. That's kind of why we're also yeah, testing this in survival now, because a quarry of that size really can't be tested, at least for the full distance. At least in the test runs that I did, we never had the issue with that, but it was like 50 slices. It's nothing compared to 4K slices. Takes 90 days. Real days. Yeah, but 90 days is no problem. We already had two other quarries that took 90 days to finish. So it's fine. It's gonna be on most of the time, yes. Lag is fine. I know it's hard to imagine for such a giant thing, but the lag's actually fine. No, FPS will be perfectly fine. Maybe we'll have some issues rendering the machine. So the moving parts at least, but rest should be good. Ah, the opaque pistons wouldn't be a big issue in this case since we have the roof. We needed it anyway because of all the Skylight updates. Ah, thanks a lot. It's Luzip for the subscription. It's really appreciated, thanks. It would actually be a bit faster if you would run it on Tick Warp. So while the main grabbers go down, it's pretty much 20 TPS, or at least I hope it is. But when it docks back in and the stone is processed, or the other blocks, then it would actually run at 50-55 TPS, so when the TNT system is running. So you would get an advantage if you would Tick Warp it, but not much. When will you finish building the quarry? Probably, or I hope at least in the next month, so in July. 9 slimes died for slime block? Okay, yeah, 500,000 slimes died for this quarry. Also plan to stream tomorrow again, maybe also again from 6 to 9 or maybe an hour later. So more progress even tomorrow again. But I have to be honest, the 12-hour stream last Saturday was maybe 2 hours too much. The last 2-3 hours, they were doing this for 24 hours, yeah, that would be much. Yes, I'm German. So what could we get rid of? Okay, see you later. Yeah, it was a bit quiet the last 3 hours, but it was okay. Doc was talking a lot, so yeah. Yeah, I could also start here with the sticky pistons. Maybe that's also the reason why it was a bit quiet. Couldn't really contribute much to that discussion. Because mostly I have to agree with Doc what he said, so... Do you guys still use the SZ in modern German? We had in school back then. No, it hasn't been abandoned. But just a while ago, they even implemented an uppercase SZ a while ago. But yeah, it's still a thing. But personally, I don't use it. I use double S for it. I don't care if it's correct or not. But yeah, don't use the SZ whenever I can. Oh god, I can't even imagine how awful it would be to build this without the Elytra. How many deaths would we have taken by now from fall damage? I remember the old 1-8 days when we did huge projects like the mob farm at the spawn chunks, how annoying it was to get back up and so on. I think for some projects we even built elevators just to get back up again when we fell down. Water bucket land. That's also a thing. Oh, ender pearls now. I think ender pearls wasn't an option back then, but ever since they also kind of start of the player's momentum, this should be an option. It should be really easy just to fall down and then throw an ender pearl, since it even has more momentum now. But it wasn't a thing back then. The ender pearl was slower than the player was falling. Okay, so the uppercase SZ is not used for anything official, however it was implemented in Unicode. And there have been some street names with SZ. Yeah, okay. I think SZ is just a bit outdated, I don't know. You could easily replace everything with a double S, that's fine. More forest fires. What a, yeah, it's still raining. Yeah. How is the delay so short on Twitch? I think back in March or April they implemented that. So I have two options now, either the old system or this short delay system, which still is a bit experimental, so it's probably not as reliable as the other one. But I'm glad that it's at least like 2 or 3 seconds in some cases. Like 15 or 20 was just too much. Hey, disaster piece. How much did you do already? So you mean today? Just built 2 of those instant lines, that's it. In total. So I built this one and that one. Yeah, nice progress for 1 hour. In total, probably 70%. So enemy started with the 7th module, 7 of 8. So this is almost finished. And then here we probably, yeah, don't have half of it. But they're getting really close. Maybe it's even 75% of what we already have. I can't check the amount of blocks today because I set the render distance, or the server render distance, back to 16. But I would say we have 310k or 420k. Really close. Let's see how much we can do today. But I have to leave at 9 because I still want to go for a short run afterwards and just use the daylight. So, yeah, 110 minutes more streaming. Then I have to really go. Otherwise, it's too dark. Couldn't you look at the slice and multiply the amount of. Not really. I think my estimate should be fairly accurate, so we don't need to check that even. I'm gonna use additional accounts of fake players to load the quarry. Because there are some issues with the chunk loading system. How much do you run usually? Not that much anymore. Like a few years ago, I've been running like 25 kilometers every day because I was, yeah, training a lot, but nowadays it's not that much anymore. So I'm doing a lot of other sports now instead of just running, and I've actually took a break recently and probably have to like start again 4 or 5 kilometers. Would be nice to just get back to 10 to 15, and that 3 times a week is enough, but yeah. Because I'm doing a lot of cycling now and some weightlifting. I joined the gym last week, so I can't really do that much running anymore. Also, going to the gym was so great for my knees. I always had so many issues with my knees, and they have those vibrating plates. It's so good just to stand there, to do some squats on those vibrating plates. I think that's gonna really help my knees, and maybe then can I do more running again, because it was the main issue recently. I just always had some pain somewhere in my body when I was running, and that also killed the fun. So I'm hoping by going to the gym and also doing some exercise for my joints, or the muscles around the joints, maybe can get back into running a bit more again. Because if you've been only doing running like I did, it's a bit, yeah, monotonous, and then really if you always do the same motion, then it really attacks your joints at some point. That probably would happen to me. Also had issues with my Achilles tendon for quite a while, but that, yeah, I got that. Okay, that works again. Yeah. How many hours to go? Maybe 40, 50. Hope it's closer to 40. But it's just the building. Afterwards, you also have to do some still removal of spawners and chests, and then debugging the whole machine, so testing it on a separate world until we're sure it works. Then we can launch it. So it's gonna take a while. You guys need to hire some people to do the dirty work. Yeah, don't make enough money for streaming on YouTube to hire people. Would make it for free. I know some people already offered to help out with projects, but I don't think this would be a good decision to allow that. So Bobby would join to do some dirty work. Yeah, maybe you can make your mem Bobby. I mean, can definitely need some people that sometimes help out, and you've been around the community for quite a while. Maybe you can ask the other guys. I mean, the more the merrier. But it's just goes for Bobby, the invitation, maybe. How do you get the motivation to run or cycle alone? Ah, I never had an issue with that, really. So I never got bored while running. Cycling is a bit different. I actually get bored while cycling. But I never had an issue to just go run for 2 or 3 hours. Also, never ran with music or anything. It was just enough just to enjoy nature. get tired without listening to music podcasts while running cycling. Yeah, I can understand it somehow for cycling. So like going for a bike tour for an hour or two is fine, but if it's longer than that, then also get bored. There's never an issue with running for some reason, but cycling definitely is. Usually I also don't go longer than 2 hours for my bike rides. 2 hours is enough, I guess. Do I bike a lot? Wouldn't say so. No. Yeah, like maybe 4 hours a week. Like 3 times a week. Twice an hour and once 2 hours. Wouldn't say that's a lot, but I'm doing other stuff as well, so. I once did a 150-kilometer tour in 5 hours and a little bit, but that was quite tough. The last 30 kilometers, that was, yeah, that was almost worse than a marathon. Do you only play Minecraft? I occasionally play other games. Not at the moment. It's been a while since I played another game. Favorite other game? Probably the Zelda series. Okay, pistons. I think the YouTube videos are still like 4 weeks behind, but I haven't recorded much in the last 4 weeks. So I just have 5 left, as far as I know. So we're getting really close again. Maybe in 2 weeks we're gonna catch up. And then I also probably have to go back to once a week. But we can alternate, maybe sometimes twice a week again, but I probably can't or keep this up with twice a week. It's just too much effort for one episode. Also, at some point, I'm probably gonna have issues coming up even with ideas of what to do. I mean, so we never do a server restart. Okay, what do I want to get? Pistons. Drankiller says, an event called Critical Mass. In most cities, I know if it's once a month, many people ride the bike through the city with some music and stuff. I've heard something similar was going on in Munich when I lived there. Yeah, sounds like fun. The moment the closed city is Nuremberg, so I don't think. Yeah, that's too far away. Just for some bike riding. Also, like once a week, I met with other people to run, because I was a member of a club. But that also definitely helped to run with people. And I had a good friend also that joined me for some runs. But it was kind of hard since I was quite decent runner, And he wasn't quite as good, so we could only do the easy runs together. So quarry is basically a contraption that will mine the whole landscape and puts the items that we get into the storage. At Ilmengo, can you show the rail duplication to spawn chunks that shoots at the nether portal, please? Oh, that's super simple, I can even build this up for what I have, just need to get some rails. God, should we have some rails somewhere? Detected rails. So golden rails would be good. Oh, do detector rails also work? Yeah, they should also work. Yeah, let's get those. So it's literally just like an L shape, then a sticky piston in the back, then just power this piston here. Two rails. Okay, that's what we also have at spawn. Ah, it works with any rails? I'm quite sure it doesn't work with the normal rails. What does it? Not entirely sure if it works with the normal rails. I think you need a rail that updates, like a golden rail or a detector rail. Yep, one normal and one non-normal, yep. My problem is the rails get stuck in the slime block. No, they always get shot forwards. Did I place all the pistons already? Lost track? No, didn't.
Thank you.
Oh, nice. Pack the ice layer. Okay. Let's continue with the pistons here. Does the quarry mine 100% of the ungravity blocks? Yeah, there's a little loss. Mostly because some items don't land on the packed ice. They sometimes could land on the side. But it's, I don't know, it's definitely 99.9% we get. Or even a bit more. But it was kind of not worth it to expand the collection area even more, because that would have meant push limit problems, and it would be insane effort just to get that last, I don't know, how much is it? Maybe we lose every 2000th block or so. Yeah, but apart from that, it's, yeah, 100%. It's also not a problem with the Nether Quartz. There's enough Nether Quartz. Don't need to get every single one. Cause then you might as well dissect it. So does generated ice load chunks? Yes. It doesn't check for light updates, or does it? No, it's getting ticked every 20 to 30 ticks, as far as I remember. And then it also basically checks the neighboring blocks, because if a packed ice isn't surrounded by at least two other packed ice blocks, then it melts immediately. And in order to check for the other blocks, it obviously, if it's on a chunk border, it has to check the next chunk. And that's why it's chunk loading is a big issue, actually. Yeah. Same with the fire blocks, they have similar issue, but I fixed it with the carpet mod. Can you pronounce Albert Einstein in German? Just did. Any chance guys decide to turn this into a perimeter? Probably not, since we don't need it. If it were 100% efficient, how much nether quartz would you have gotten? The palace quarry was actually only like 98% or 99% efficient, but we still got 500,000. If we would have gotten like 5k more, it would have made a big difference. Can you suggest a theoretical way to farm quartz? I don't understand the question. So you mean like we implemented ways on the Patreon server to farm Elytra? Is this something I would like, or what do you mean with that? You definitely can't do it in vanilla. A new mob. I don't like the idea of having renewable quartz, to be honest. I'm perfectly fine with the quartz ores. Instead, at least gives a reason to make quarries. And you can still get a ton by making a quarry. Same for diamonds. Diamond ore is perfectly fine. Oh, Panic is on the server, didn't even notice. Yeah, Panic. Just placing this last row of slime, almost finished, and then coming over. No, diamonds are unfarmable. I mean, not renewable. You can make kind of a diamond farm, yeah. Stone button perimeter, okay. Gonna use the piston wheel drive to take a short break, be back in 2 minutes. Okay, we have arrived. I'm back. Oh, looks good. Oh my god. Okay. Is Panic saying something? We should go. Probably leave the area so we can drop them in an unloaded chunks. So full sync.
Yeah, I think I will just join voice chat.
Okay, that's easy. Okay. So you're just gonna run it through, or what?
Yeah. I try to, at least.
Okay.
Since you're streaming, it has a 100% chance to fail, so... Yeah. Let's hope I set everything up correctly. Okay, wanna come to the unloaded chunks?
Yeah. Just got a one bit cheer. My last cheer for you, dude. By the way, can you teach me how to use redstone? It's, I don't know. Maybe watch the videos that I make on YouTube.
Accidentally
I don't give private lessons if you're asking for that.
Accidentally made that antenna twice as long because I thought we were still at 32.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Let's hope everything works. Oh, what did I wrong?
Push limit? Subserver didn't trigger.
Oh. Oh yeah, true. I made that part too long. Yep. I should maybe do it closer. I think it activated once, right?
I don't think this moved at all.
Okay.
But you can activate it more often anyway, right?
Yep. Should be able to update it. Didn't move now? Nope.
It did move, yeah.
Okay. Let's just wait. Try it out once. You can run it through. Okay. Flying back, check if it worked.
Hey, Jens.
So far, so good. Didn't remove any battery cap because I built it one far out.
So this is okay if there's some netherrack attached here? This is intended. Oh, it's just some.
That's just.
Okay, let's break
blocks.
The eggs. Okay.
We need, yep. Okay, we broke the. There are some blocks, okay. Should work.
Oh, you can protect the area below?
Yeah, first I protected the area here on the top, as you can see, I placed.
But then it just falls straight through.
Yeah, exactly. So okay. I placed the center bottom as well. But I think. Looks good.
Okay.
I think we can run it.
Wait, can you attach an engine? It still works.
Last time I just placed slime blocks and removed them to update the piston.
Okay. I also have a flipped steel.
Oh, okay. Yeah, don't have one at the moment. Should be easier. But now the.
How should it work? Should I.
Yeah.
What? What's going on with that? Oh, why did you place?
Yeah. I know why. I know why. Because the piston is powered while the thing should move. Now it should work. Yes, that looks better.
Can I activate it every few seconds?
Yeah, just activate it a few times and then we check again.
Mm-hmm.
That works then. I think at the front there are one pushing and two pulling it extension attached, so should work really fast.
Okay. That was like 9-10 times.
Yeah.
Should we go back?
Yeah, okay. Looks good. The machine hasn't crashed yet and bedrock been removed. Yep. Okay.
Okay.
Promising. I will just grab some rockets and go back. Okay. Man, those melons and dragon so long to place.
Hey, what's that in the back? Are those the old Schalke?
Yep.
Switches? Not sure if we should go near that.
I flew around earlier.
They're completely encased, right?
Yes.
Okay. We even have a moth switch here.
Yeah, I was confused when I saw that earlier because that area never were in that area.
Yeah, I just drove them out like 500 blocks, so. They don't interfere with anything. Okay. Yeah, that doesn't work in 1.13.
You can activate it.
Oh yeah. How bad was placing the melon blocks in Dragon Eggs?
I think it took 5 to 7 hours. I'm not sure. Worked on it yesterday and watched some movies while I did that. It's not too bad because with Trikaru, you don't have to shift click all the time when placing Dragon Eggs. If you place one dragon egg, then with Trico you can place dragon eggs really quickly.
Okay.
If you have a strip already, that play phase thing. Oh, don't have any. you can run along and you don't have to press click.
No, that makes it a lot more convenient, I guess. You can actually observe the bedrock getting removed if you stand in the right chunk. So you just need to stand basically in a chunk where the chunks that are getting removed or the bedrock is getting removed is in a lazy chunk. Then you can actually observe it. The surrender distance also displays...
Oh, with a really high MS? Ah, probably because of all the melon blocks and so on.
Should we check again?
Yeah, okay. Just remove the string that I had here.
Yeah, rip TPS. It's pretty bad.
Oh, let's see how how it is when we go near and all those get entity loaded.
It's also the melons.
That's what I meant. Yeah. The melon.
Oh my god.
Entities. Oh, but oh god. Now all the dragon eggs fell down. Oh god. Let's hope we don't crash the server.
Uh-oh.
I think they landed. That looks really good.
I think they stacked up.
Yeah.
Kind of worked. But maybe we should pick up those 3,000 entities.
Yes. But those are probably all stacked, so we need a lot of Schalke boxes for that.
Mostly a client problem, because we still have just 30 MSPT.
Yeah, items aren't that bad for MSPT. I guess we can just run it more or not. Because picking those up there, it's no option.
Yeah, that's
because,
insane.
I think those were at least 20 Schalke boxes for half of it, and then I grabbed some more.
I don't think we have to... we have to watch Dog Fix on, yeah.
Okay.
Leaves would have been better, but yeah, hard to farm.
I mean, you can see here, this one was the road just for melons, and I used it up to here.
Okay.
Those were a lot of melons and also a lot of dragon eggs.
But, just burn
those
it?
Those don't really matter.
Let's just despawn it. It's probably better.
Yeah. I guess we can continue, right?
Maybe we should do it in bursts of 20.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Especially those melons, those are a lot of items. because, as I said, I used up 20 Schalker boxes of melons, and now the melons are all broken and are melon slices.
You could have switched to pumpkins afterwards.
Oh yeah, true. Yeah, I didn't think about that.
Oh, are you here? Almost activated.
Oh, no, no. Yeah, oh, okay.
Still back at the core, at the
scene? Yeah.
Oh, good that I didn't click the button.
Should have watched the stream for that. Okay. I'm here now.
Okay.
When you said you wanted to do it in batches of 20, I thought you want to wait 5 minutes every 20
rolls. No, no, no.
We despawn all the items. Should we go there again?
It was 14.
Okay. Yeah, it didn't count.
This will increase the rates of the farm. Since for the mob spawning algorithm, always the highest opaque block is important, and we can lower kind of the highest opaque block by removing the bedrock. Bedrock is also opaque. Okay.
Yep. I think it should around triple the rates of the farm, because the farm is the...
Maybe
it should double it, yeah. Double it. Oh, now we crashed.
We did? Oh no.
Not somehow crashed.
Oh boy.
I don't know what happened there.
Could it be that it not properly unloaded?
That could be because I just flew in and then you activated it. Yeah, I guess I will just remove the dragon eggs, remove the bedrock below. Somehow, no, that's not an option, really.
I guess you have to do this manually. Somehow.
It's probably easier to build, rebuild the big machine than do it by hand.
Okay.
I didn't even make a schematic for the full machine. I only had a part of it and had to move it around.
Maybe we should also wait like 2 minutes before we activate it, because I'm quite sure sometimes the player unloading doesn't work 100% for chunks. Yeah, I think that was.
And also,
issue
what
again.
Happened to those bottom strips here?
They got fucked.
the machine drove further. Oh man.
Oof.
That's a big oof here.
That sucks, yeah.
Well, the machine is set up quicker than all the melons and dragon eggs.
I think maybe the like first 10 still worked, right?
Yeah.
How did it break then? Server rollback is not an option, really.
No. Could it be that we loaded a 5x5 somehow? No.
So here's the chunk border. Could be, maybe.
Nah.
Nah, definitely not.
We have the permaloader running, right? So the chunks here in the back aren't unloaded, or not?
The player should just usually unload them while flying away. That's why I thought maybe that failed.
Oh yeah, true. No. I don't know. I will just rebuild the machine, it's not that hard.
Okay. Have you ever tested it in creative first? If this
I mean, I used it for the strip to make space for that machine.
Okay.
So I used it in a small scale version along this row here, just two or three segments,
mm-hmm.
and that worked. But
yeah, I don't know what's the issue.
This one is wider. Maybe it actually loaded some chunks and they loaded or so. I don't know.
Oh yeah, but how's the progress with the roof builder?
Haven't worked on it.
Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna head back to the quarry.
Yeah, okay. I think I will either help with that or go offline again.
Rage quit.
Nah, it's not that bad. I just wanted to run the machine and yeah. You saw the TPS, don't want to ruin your stream for that.
I'm actually surprised the dragon eggs even fall down.
What do you mean? We destroyed a block? Oh no, we destroyed a block.
Wait,
and then
yeah, the chunks are loaded. Yeah, they should fall down. Yeah, okay. What happens now in 1.13? Do the entities and lazy chunks no longer fall down instantly, or does just the dragon egg land the right spot? How did it get fixed? Do you know?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe they are just like sand, so they fall down instantly, but don't land a block too low.
Probably, yeah. Wait, you could have stayed at the top. It can. Yeah, the bedrock breaking was a one-line bug, basically. They messed something up. As far as I know, they didn't copy-paste the code correctly. And then the X just landed a block lower than usually. Hey, Connie.
The worst thing is now cleaning up the mess that the Dragon X made at the bottom.
Yeah, maybe the next time we take a backup if we try it again.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Hey.
Hey.
What is easier to set up, piston bolt or pearl can? I would say the pearl can. It's kind of annoying to do all the chunk loading and all the calculations for it, but I think it's less effort.
Yeah, for a distance where Perl can make sense, I think the piston bolt would be definitely more effort.
Okay,
but if you need to travel like 500 blocks, a cannon is not worth it, you know?
It is?
500? I don't think so.
just load all the chunks, the pearl flies. Don't have to do any calculations, just an instant wire and that's all.
Bye, Dragon Killer. Is the world down for a pearl cannon somewhere? I think XCOM made one, as far as I know. That's schematic. Probably better to play stop servers actually.
The weirdest thing is that it skipped two rows and after that the dragon is removed bedrock again.
Yeah, there's some weird issues. We also had that with the banner bedrock removal. But sometimes it didn't work.
Yeah, I had the same. Not sure why. I thought maybe the banners loaded, if you do it in large scale, the banners loaded chunks around and then somehow made it entity load processing, but in that case, yeah.
Quite sure that the player unloading of the chunks didn't work properly, and then, hated word, I was confused with probably.
Yeah, same.
And then you had entity loading chunks and it just didn't work. So I'm quite sure if you maybe wait the next time 5 minutes, not five, maybe 2 or 3 minutes, then it should work. But on the other hand, it worked like for the first 10 rows or so. That's what I don't get.
What bedrock are you breaking?
For the
Widow's farm.
We hope we can start it in early August. Never played Factorio. Bobby always suggests to play Factorio. Yeah. Have you ever played Enemy?
No, I have not.
Yeah. From what I've heard, I would probably like it, and that's the problem. Don't need another time sink, to be honest.
I found a last fun time sink last night. Copying 100 MB text files around.
Sounds fun.
At a data rate of like, I don't know, 10 MB per minute. Then waiting for them to load and open, and then copying them into Excel and waiting for that, and then copying, moving them around some more, and then like having, I don't know, a 25 MB Excel file out of like 100 MB text file with the same data inside, which makes no sense. quite sure. Some bit flipped, and the end of the text file is just like some bytes that don't resemble any text characters anymore, and it's just like filling up space.
The item gets stuck on a slime block. I don't get that. Looks perfectly fine. Do you maybe play a different Minecraft version?
Plays on Xbox.
I mean, it doesn't take long if the pearl can check it out at spawn. Yeah, there's not much really going on, except Mesa Quarry building. So I think that's why there are not that many interactions. Alright, let's go to spawn. Also, I found a nice trick how to find where to go. We actually have the coordinates in the top left corner, just have to go up to approximately 0, 0.
You can also always go in the direction where there's the block on top. I told you that 6 times, but you always not read the limit. Just go in the direction of the block you always find.
Or even my own system now.
I'm using the chunk loading at the bottom. Just the opposite side of the chunk loading is the way to go.
Yeah, the direction the wind doesn't go over. Let's come up with more convoluted ways to find the right direction.
But somehow my chunks load way faster than Mango's, but we have a similar graphics card.
So yeah, that's good. System. I think maybe methods placed the extra slime block at the top. Maybe that fixes it. I don't know. Yeah, but there's really nothing special about it.
I really like Nambin's design for the portal clock that recycles the items. Because, well, you don't have to dupe. If you don't have to dupe, you don't...
Wait, which system?
Knembin showed it
Oh, okay. I talked about this like 10 times already. I think I've answered this question 1-8 already. So, because of the portal situation, it would be so much effort to send the item back.
Oh, okay.
I think when I quite soon after I joined the server, we tried it out a little bit. And we had like at 180 in the spawn chunk somewhere in the corner, up high. We had a portal floating around in the test world to try it out, but the linking was so horrible.
Okay.
And you had a portal in the sky that like didn't work as well.
Oh yeah, this is normal. The Pearl can sometimes doesn't work with the extreme, it's called the extreme values of the Pearl throw. If it goes too much to left or right, then it just bounces against the block. But it's not an issue. That's why we have to detect the double string detection system. Only if it goes through both strings, then the can is activated. Probably the best if we start with the pack dice. Uh, 720 white, Corey.
Rejoice!
Oh, hey, Rego! How's it going? So I'm tired.
Ever so slightly. Maybe because I was traveling for like 20 hours last night.
He had problems, right? With the flight?
We booked a bit unfortunate, it was a bit tight to catch a train, like a late one, or the latest one still going the same day after the airport. But then my luggage didn't arrive, because they basically didn't manage to put it from one aircraft into the other on time when I had to switch.
Okay.
Because the first one was delayed, and now actually my luggage just arrived with the... Yeah, someone brought it here, place. But yeah, so you have to look after your luggage and stuff, then of course you don't catch your train anymore, and you have to wait like 4 hours for the next train, which is then a slower one. So I arrived sometime 6 o'clock this morning.
Can I ask from where you traveled?
Southern Italy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was quite nice, though a bit exhausting.
Business trip, right?
Program. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Otherwise, I don't get out of here. Well, it was a pretty cool thing.
Raghu, I suggest you checking out one of the last messages in the Dump Memes and Convos channel. Mojang did the stupidest pun they ever did and basically roasted themselves.
Hmm?
Have you seen it, Mango?
Yeah, that's not really new.
It's not new? Okay. Haven't seen it yet.
Rego is signed because he claims copyright. The strike now.
Oh, we should have placed another road and we could have placed three blocks like this. I think it's not too late. Are the pearl cannons autosave proof? No, they aren't, unfortunately. I think they broke twice already and then we had to fix them manually. We thought about hack fixing them, so they would at least fix themselves. That might be a thing we could do, similar to what we did with the permaloader. They also go above the weld angle a few times, that's also a big issue with it. I think by now we can fix it maybe in 10-15 minutes, right, Rago? If it breaks again. If the pearl can breaks again, we can fix it maybe in 10-15 minutes.
What's the
chunk loading. Or the instant repeaters, yeah, for the pearl can, yeah. What was that?
I'm waiting for the day where someone tells me that I built it all wrong.
This machine won't work in 1.13 now. There's multiple things that are different. And we won't update to 1.13 anyway. Yeah, I'm quite sure we're gonna skip it entirely. Update to 1.14 if it's any good.
Well, if they add the arrows getting stuck into creatures, then we definitely have to.
Maybe. But I just heard that they broke chunk loading today with hoppers. That's even another reason to not update. Remotely tempting would be node blocks and pot soul, but we can easily add it with carpet ourselves if we want it now. Fish farms, not really, no. Tridents, nah.
Also, we can live quite easily without node blocks and pot soul, so.
Yeah. But can you live without sea pickles?
So last stage 6 years, so I don't see why we couldn't.
Drowned dropping clay is nice, but we kinda decided what to use on our Patreon server now. Yeah, when XCOM has some time to implement it. So we want to kind of wash dirt in order to get clay balls. And in order to make it more challenging, you need to use pot soil now. And then, yeah, basically you click on a filled cauldron, and then the cauldron is emptied. And the pot soil block in your hand would be converted into a clay ball. That's what we're gonna do. It's definitely not overpowered since there's a lot of steps involved. But it's a renewable resource now since we can... we added renewable gravel. With the gravel you can make dirt. You can take dirt and convert it into pot soil.
You convert it into the coarse dirt.
Yeah, it coarse dirt and then make the coarse dirt into dirt by making it farmland first and breaking it. And I can make the pot soil.
How do you make the pot soil out of dirt?
Yeah, we're gonna add the Nessie said it's really easy to add that as well, the mechanic. With the spruce trees.
Ah, oh, okay. I saw one thing someone suggested, it was like, coarse dirt underwater over time turns into clay.
Yeah. Would actually work since it doesn't generate naturally underwater. But is it fun to automate it or make something? I don't know.
Definitely, maybe.
It would be similar to like the grass farm, pretty much.
Still need to craft the coarse dirt.
I think it's more interesting to use the cauldron mechanic. Right. At the moment we don't have a Wizard Skull farm, but Panic is working on it. I'm gonna end the stream at 9. So 40 more minutes. Clay ball dropped by silverfish? Not really. Would be not really interesting and also kinda slow. Ah yeah, 9 PM German time. So, top left corner, I always see German time. We can completely ignore the leaf blocks as far as I can tell. They shouldn't interfere with the redstone at all. The only issue I could see is if we build it in front or in the trajectory of the TNT. But yeah, that shouldn't do that. Can't complain about 8 MSPT, especially with 3 players on the server. There probably also tons of animals around, at least the enemy and me. Then we also still have the hoppers at spawn, which is also maybe half an MSPT? Let's check actually. So where's the lag coming from? There's entities, it's the animals, tile entities, yeah, the stuff that spawn. Blocks, so there's probably like grass gets random ticked and so on. Bit of spawning algorithm. Probably for bats and squids. Nether, yeah, this is panic stuff. Yeah, it's pretty good. Can't complain about anything. Yeah. The ice is for the item transport. Skip more. The quarry is also moving the ice, yes. The whole item collection system is movable. Can take a look at it. Oh, no more rockets. Let's go into Game of Three for to show that. Okay, so here we dupe the TNT. TNT flies over in a nice trajectory, breaks the stone blocks here. Everything falls down on top of those ice blocks. Here we have the water, which is generated in front of the frosted ice mechanic. And then everything flows to the side. On the full length of the hole, it has to be built this low so the TNT doesn't blow the items at the bottom. Which is the advantage that we had to make this really wide, since the items could have a bit momentum to the side and could in some cases also land here on those border blocks. So we lose maybe every 2000th item. And there we go. Here everything is then put into a single water stream, and the sorting system will be attached here somehow. But that's not part of the schematic, we have to figure this out. Since we're not quite sure how to do it yet. Alright. Is item travel time a problem? Shouldn't be. No. So there are no more items in this thing here in case the quarry moves forwards. Or are there? Oh, actually, there could be some items left. But it shouldn't matter at all. Just also get pushed over. Okay, let's continue with the ice. Yeah, I don't use the offhand very often. Wouldn't say never use it. No, it just rather scroll through my hotbar in order to get the food. Kinda don't like it if I have the food item always in the left part of my screen. And even if I would use a texture pack that makes it invisible, I still wouldn't like it. I don't know. No, it doesn't hurt. You can actually get it on Suzuma's homepage as part of the Vanilla Tweaks texture pack. I think it's more in a fun category. How can I make this quarry less laggy? Make it smaller.
Make stuff around it less laggy. Come up with a better design.
Oh, that's... Yeah. Enemy and I are working on a quarry. About 310,000 blocks have been placed. There's about 100k left. And last Saturday with the 12-hour stream definitely was a big step forwards. Hey Cold Shiver. I played on 4 or 5 servers before Cycroft. One more long stream. It was really hard. No more frequent, shorter streams. It's just better. No, none of the other servers were technicals. just normal public servers, and also played on one modded server. I think I got banned on three servers, and then I joined another server. That was actually quite good for a year or so, but it just wasn't technical enough, and they also had a modded version with some limitations, like I couldn't use a wizard to break blocks and so on. That's why I chose to not play on that server anymore. And at some point, I got asked by the Cycroft guys in order if I wanted to join. Why did you get banned? I don't know. Mostly because of exploiting game mechanics. Trading lag? Yeah, on the modded server. But instead of saying, maybe don't build this or that, it got banned straight away for causing lag on a modded server. Kind of ridiculous. So I'm kind of glad that I now play on a reliable server, not those stupid public servers anymore. Missed the block. No, we'll see you on the way back. Like hearing audiobooks? I don't. Usually I just enjoy focusing on one thing completely, and then I might as well just read the book. I tried it once to hear an audiobook while running. One time. It's so annoying. A favorite book? Say Hotel New Hampshire was quite good. Like that one a lot.
Metro 2033.
Oh, another really good book that I liked, probably also the favorite book, was The Magician by William Somerset Maugham. But it's kind of hard to say it's a favorite book, just really enjoyed reading it. I'm not that much into books, to be honest. About 75% of the quarry is done. Maybe in terms of total effort, even closer to 85 or even 90% since we've done all of that tunnel boring already. Oh, Frankenstein is also sounds interesting. Okay. Good idea to place the observers now. Oh no, the terracotta would be better. Enemies also building the quarry, and Penning is working on some bedrock removal. Yeah, enemy is working on the 7th module. So that part is also almost finished. Not the Project Skyblock, no. For the Wizard Skeleton Farm. So you might remember that quarry we did last year in the Nether, the 360 one. Building the Skeleton Farm there, the Wizard Skeleton Farm. Oh yeah, also have to check. Are those terracotta blocks real? Because we had an issue with copy client, which resulted, yeah, in ghost blocks. So we have to place them in a certain angle, then it's okay.
I just do it by hand.
Never.
XCOM also uploaded the fix for that yesterday, so...
Ah, oh, sweet.
Yeah, can just download that.
Mm-hmm. I'll do it next time.
Yep.
What I actually look forward to the most is all the trees that are getting pushed together in front of the quarry. Can't wait to see that.
Oh, that would look so cool.
Yeah.
In general, that giant wall of doom that will look so epic.
Okay, it looks wrong, but those are real. Okay.
I'm just waiting for it to like move one block and then blow up in a giant explosion.
Yeah, we're gonna see that a few times on the testing server, I guess. Also we still need to add the gravity block breaking at the bottom, or the slabs in front of the machine.
Oh yeah, true. But that shouldn't be hard, right? Just
no, it should be quite
butt simple. Line and then some slabs in front.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just slap it in.
Oh yeah, another pun for the pun counter. Awesome.
Total
166. Oh god.
Ah, those are rookie numbers. We gotta up them a bit.
Okay, just gonna fly over it again. See if maybe we've got some blocks.
It was so nice when Rego was on vacation.
Yeah.
I wasn't even on vacation.
Didn't look like it.
Well, I'm not the one choosing the conference venue.
About 25%. So that includes some of the more awful stuff, like building the dupers, and especially yeah, working on the frosted ice stuff here in front. So here, that's needs to be done by hand, the frosted ice here. I also can't wait to see it running, but probably another month or so until you can see that. The village is doomed, just that one building. I'm quite sure there should be another village somewhere in the area that's getting mined. Not been 13. I haven't seen the new pre-release at all yet. Is anything important? Nope, okay. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if you see another 4 or 5 pre-releases. Not at all. And also can guarantee you that 1.13 flat also won't be bug-free.
But I think it's a good thing that we have so many pre-releases. It shows that they're still working on it.
Yeah, I would say about 40 more hours building this thing. And then also some minor stuff. Yeah, we haven't even talked about that yet. We also need to cap some of them, the higher mountains. So maybe to remove like 500 blocks or something we need to do. Is this week a reasonable finish time? Not at all. Early August. Unless we do another long stream. But at least not this weekend. Yeah, it's a carpet feature, which will become a vanilla feature. Don't forget the 24-hour stream with Panic, yeah. Don't think he has plans for that yet.
No, not yet. Just look through the update infos for pre-6. And the first point is change dolphin treasure finding behavior to be more in parity with Bedrock Edition. That sounds awful.
Really important.
And other than that, it's just some improved fonts and some sound change. Oh, and they brought out the bug spray, so. Either they sprayed some the bug spray. So either they sprayed some bugs in the version or they actually removed some. Could be both.
What happened there? Oh, ghost blocks. Oh shoot. A ton of ghost blocks. Have to go back and get more terracotta even. Hi Daniel. Yeah, I'm quite sure I placed him. Placed him in the wrong direction. That's why it doesn't work. Oh, this was the carpet bug, but it's fixed already. Yeah, happy birthday, Panic.
Oh god. Not that again.
Happy birthday.
Superbrot with the birthday bit, thanks.
Yeah, it's Panic's birthday though.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. I transferred at 1 cent.
I get the same if I just re-register my bank card on PayPal, because they always transfer that 1 cent to make sure it's the right bank account.
In the beginning, they transferred a random amount, like between 1 cent and, I don't know, 80 cent or so.
Okay.
I think I got 38 cents from them.
No, that's always 1 cent. Maybe somebody abused it in order to get a lot of cents. Could imagine.
Oh, someone wrote the bot just to click on re-register all the time or so.
Maybe. No. Alright, almost finished that layer, but yeah, that's gonna end the stream at 9 since I need to go for a run while there's still daylight. Alright, I'm gonna check if there's somebody we could raid again. And I'm gonna stream tomorrow again. Again, 3 hours of Mesa Quarry building, so we can finish this soon. Alright, who's streaming Minecraft? Harvester of Energy. Okay, I think we can raid her again. Okay, I'm gonna send you over to Harvest of Energy. Yeah, enjoy. Okay, I'm gonna send you over to gonna
see you next time.
Yeah, gonna see you next time. Tomorrow. Probably gonna start streaming at 6 or 7 again. For 3 hours. Yeah, sorry to everyone who just came. But as always, Wednesday from 6 to 9 streaming. Okay, bye guys.
Bye bye.
Bye.
Also.